My name is Lev Barshevsky. This is Studio One. And let me introduce our guest. That's Mr. William Colton, Assemblyman. Mr. Colton represents the 47th Assembly District, and he is a lifelong resident in this district, which would mean that he knows everything about this district and the people who reside here. No, I'm serious. I think you know everything about the issues, about the problems, about the concerns the people of your district have. We cannot talk about everything, but I think we will focus on the main issues that you as a legislator now most concern. But first of all, I would like to ask you, I know that you've done a lot, and for your latest achievement, if I can say so, that's a legislation about that's a package of legislation about the combat the heroin in New York, yes. The state of New York. So please, a little bit about that.
Well, this was legislation that was just passed this June. It is a package of bills in which it takes a very broad approach to dealing with a very serious problem. So many young people are addicted to heroin, and it is a big problem. The package goes, there's part of it, which is an enforcement part. It makes it a Class C felony for somebody to illegally prescribe drugs and heroin and other addictive drugs. It makes it a Class C felony. But it also requires and encourages treatment, which is a very important part of it. For example, it has provisions which mandate that the insurance company has to cover more of the treatment. Mm-hmm. And they can, and if they deny the treatment while an appeal is going on, monies have to be provided for the treatment. That's one part of it. Another part of it is OASIS is provided a mandate to have more treatment programs and to expand their programs. So it's a multifaceted approach where it helps law enforcement by making stricter penalties, also giving them more tools in terms of wiretaps and investigative tools. But on the other hand, it requires and encourages treatment for those, especially young people, who have been addicted to it. One of the provisions of it, for example, is very often parents cannot control their own children. They lose control. And they go to the court and ask the court to basically declare the children as people in need of supervision, where the parent is not able to control the child. Well, very often that is because there's drugs, that the child has become addicted to drugs. And so this legislation requires that in that setting where the court has to deal with a parent who said, I can't control my child, the court has to look into providing treatment for that child. Evaluation to see whether there is a drug problem, and if there is a drug problem, get treatment for that child rather than simply putting the child in some foster home or juvenile, you know, detention facility, try to get the child the treatment that may be the reason why the parent can't control the child. So it's very important legislation. And I think it's something that, you know, is going to be absolutely very helpful in this great problem that
yes.
we face.
And there is alarming statistics that in the state of New York, they confiscated, if I'm not mistaken, one third of all heroin in the country.
Yes, that's correct.
So it's a very important thing. And you mentioned the young generation. I know that before becoming a legislator, for 11 years you worked as a teacher in the schools. I can understand that the future of the young generation is very important for you. And having said that, I want to mention that recently you hosted, together with Mr. Traeger, the councilman, the enrollment in the pre-kindergarten in New York.
Yes.
That's, as I understand, also a very important part of your activity, right?
That's correct. This legislation that we passed again this year in the budget is really very historic, because what it does is it sets aside $300 million for New York City to implement a universal full-day pre-kindergarten program. And the statistics have shown that where you have children who go into this pre-K program, that they are much better prepared to do well in future years. So this, you know, this was a program that the mayor had advocated, and most people, you know, did not think that it would ever get through the legislature. But it did get through. I was one of the, you know, spokespersons very strongly supporting pre-K education. And now, of course, the problem is going to be, and this is why we hosted this meeting, now that we have $300 million to implement pre-K, the city has to do it. Mm-hmm. They have to find the seats, they have to find the certified teachers, and they've got to do the recruitment. Because if they don't do it, then the money will go back to the state.
Okay.
So we must make sure that the $300 million is spent on, you know, pre-K and get that implemented in the next 2 years.
And you were instrumental in this funding of this program, right?
Yes, that is true. Where, you know, this is something that I had believed in for many years, and, you know, we were fighting, but we were doing it up until now in increments. We would, you know, add another $50 million, another $25 million. But this year, we were able to get the legislature to give $300 million to New York City this year and $300 million next year. Okay. And now the burden is upon the city administration to use that money well and make sure that we have the seats for those parents who want their children to go. It's not mandatory. It's only for parents who want their children to go to pre-K. But, you know, there's long waiting lists already. And parents are complaining that they can't find a pre-K program near their house, near where they live. So already, you know, we're beginning to see problems, and we have to make sure we work to resolve those problems and get those seats created.
Okay. What other issues on your agenda now? Let me guess, the Hurricane Sandy recovery, senior issues.
This is very important. One of the things I am most proud of is that we helped elect a young man who worked for me for 10 years as city councilman, the first Russian-speaking member of the city council, Mark Traeger. Mm-hmm. And Mark Traeger is now chair of the city council committee that deals with Sandy issues. And we really are so proud of him, because what he has been doing is he's been blowing the whistle and saying, hey, you know, all these monies are available. How much have you spent on actually helping people rebuild their houses? How much have you spent on businesses, giving to businesses that need to be rebuilt? And the sad answer was, very little. They really have not done, people have not gotten the benefit of those monies yet, and he's insisting that they do, and I think he's, you know, demanding that they do. So that's something that we're very proud of, because Mark, you know, is kind of like, you know, he's like your child. A child that has grown up and been successful, and now he is succeeding in doing the things that need to be done to speak up on behalf of people. So that's one issue that, you know, is very important. A couple of other issues in the neighborhood. One is we're still fighting that garbage station. The mayor is still going ahead with that plan. We have a court case, which I am the attorney on. I'm also one of the parties to it, and we are fighting it. We're appealing, you know, right now in the appellate division. And we intend to continue fighting it. This is the only one of the garbage stations where they have not yet built it. The others are all being built. Two of the four are already pretty much completed. One is going to open up this fall, the one in Hamilton Avenue, which is a good location, by the way. It's not residential. It's basically a waterfront area. It doesn't need dredging, so it doesn't have to contaminate the environment. And that was actually a good choice. The one in Queens is very close to completion now. The one in Manhattan, they've been building for about a year, and they're still fighting that one, because that is a residential area. And we are fighting the one here on Shore Parkway and 26th Avenue, which is going to poison the waters of all southern Brooklyn.
Okay. Thank you very much. I think that this meeting is very important, at least for our audience, because, as you know, your constituents, your voters want to know better. The politicians want to know what they're doing, that they are achieving, what issue they are facing. And I would like to thank you for coming. It was an honor to talk to you, and I wish you all the best in your future and job, which I very highly.
I am honored to be here. And, you know, this is something that is very good, because it gets information out to people And where people have information, we bring them together and they fight together to do the things that are necessary to make a better neighborhood. So I think that's, you know, something very important. And I, you know, compliment you and praise you for making this possible, because this is how people become informed and therefore they're able to fight the fights that benefit everybody in our community of Southern Brooklyn.
Thank you very much, Assemblyman William Colton. Thank you.
Thank you now.